हेलो एवरीवन, वी विल जस्ट वेट फॉर मोर 5 मिनट्स, देन वी विल स्टार्ट विद आवर सेशन. हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज प्रियंका शिंदे, डिजिटल स्ट्रेटजिस्ट ऑफ सिनर्जेटिक्स आईटी सर्विसेज. सो होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेल, एंड आई होप यू कैन ऑल हियर मी. सो कैन एनीवन जस्ट गिव मी अ फीडबैक, कैन यू ऑल आर हियर मी?
Yes, it is audible.
Thank you so much. So, Synergetics took one step through this COVID 19 situation. We have started a series of webinars, virtual meetups, and workshop and training. So, today our webinar is on how to attend online tests and how you can prepare just by sitting home for this online certifications. So, the agenda of today's webinar is about online exam, the things you can do before scheduling the exam, then system test, understanding the testing station protocol, then how to take the exam, check-in process, support options, and online exam FAQ, and video walkthrough. So this is the agenda for today's webinar. So the speaker for the today's webinar is Ms. Ashwini Shahane. She is the president at Synergetics and cloud architect and Microsoft certified trainer. So I'll just give a brief introduction about our today's speaker. The speaker for today's webinar is Ms. Ashwini Shahane. She is president of Synergetics IT services. Also, she is a Microsoft certified trainer. She always believes in keeping herself up to date with latest technologies, and so that is why she is the best speaker for today's webinar to guide all of you about the certification and their exams and how you can attend the exam just by sitting at home. So she has more than 30 plus years of experience in this industry, and she has given training to many employees from big Fortune companies like Intel, then Microsoft, Accenture, Capgemini, and many more companies. So my words are very less to describe her great work and experience in this industry. And she is the best option for all of you to guide you about the online certifications and exam. So before we start the webinar, just I want to give a quick announcement regarding our Synergetics public training calendar. So you can all of you can see the calendar of our upcoming certification exam, so training. So these all the trainings are virtual public live workshops. So you can just enroll, just visit our website and enroll for the certifications. So this calendar is available on Synergetics IT services website. And if you want this calendar, just ping me or just mail me. I'll just forward this calendar to you. And one more announcement is there. So we, as I told you, we have took one step during this situation. So we have come with a free live training on AZ 900 Microsoft Azure Fundamentals. So this is a one whole day training which is happening on tomorrow, Thursday, 30th April 2020, which is started from 9:30 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. And this live training is free of cost. So you can just enroll for this training and can attend whole day training by tomorrow. Okay. Thank you all. Thank you for joining this webinar. After this webinar, I'll just forward you a feedback form. Just help me with that feedback form so we can arrange more trainings and workshop or webinars like this for all of you. So now we can start with our webinar. Hello, ma'am. Ashwini, ma'am, if you can start with the webinar.
Just give me 2 minutes. I'm sharing my screen. Hello, everybody. Hope you're doing well. This is Ashwini here, and welcome to this webinar on how to take an online exam. So let's start. You know the agenda. Priyanka has already spoken about the agenda. We'll be covering, you know, what are online exams, what are the things you need to do before the exam, before you even register for the exam, during the exam and after the exam. We'll have some quick video walkthroughs also so that you understand each and every process. And there's a small FAQ also at the end. And we will then leave it open to Q&A. Now we are going through some difficult times, right? COVID situation has really put us through a lot of trouble. All of us are, facing things like we cannot travel, we are stuck at home, social distancing is becoming the new norm, work from home, right? So a lot of negatives that we are, kind of dealing with. So rather than kind of focusing on the negatives, why not, try to convert them into positives? There was a message that was sent by one of my colleagues and a few things that I picked up from there. Like what are the things that we used to do in the past and how were the things in the past? How was the working environment in the past and how is it changing today? So in the past, we had a 9-to-5 or a 9-to-6 job. Of course, in the IT world, that is sometimes rare. But today's new is work anytime, right? You are working, you're available all the time. You can, adjust your day, you can adjust your routines according to what you need, right? Earlier we used to be, working in an office, we had to go to office every day. Traveling was a very big factor that was there, especially in Mumbai. I'm sure everybody agrees. It used to be a pain traveling in locals and it used to take us hours sometimes to reach our workplace. Today's new is, of course, you can work from anywhere. Right, so you don't need to be in Mumbai today. People are working online virtually all the time, right? So what is becoming the new norm? Is this the new normal? Is this digital virtual world that we are in? So when we have this time, when we are at home, right, why not use this time to skill and certify ourselves? Why not make our technical skills better? Why not enhance our CVs and do that? Now to do that, first of all, how is learning changing, right? So if you look at learning, earlier it used to be, or we were used to instructor-led training. A lot of millennials, of course, are used to online training and online learning, but some of the veterans like me are still used to in-person trainings and we yet prefer that. Some kind of trainings, the belief is that, it is better when done with in-person training, like when you have some skills to build and so on. But today this is changing and we are forced to change it. Right? Today we are forced to adopt a new type of learning, whether it is virtual ILTs, right, where it is yet instructor-led, but not in person. You are virtually attending a program. Right? Similarly, you're also moving to self-paced. Right? So a lot of training is moving towards virtual ILT and self-paced learning. Right? But with this kind of learning style, where companies are also promoting self-paced learning a lot, where you have learning portals that are being built by companies, e-learning is becoming common. How does an organization or how does an individual verify the learning or the knowledge or the skills that have been gained, right? So there has to be some kind of verification, which is typically, what is accepted is some kind of certification, right? So again, especially from a Microsoft perspective, even the way the Microsoft certifications have been designed now has changed. Today, we have more role-based certifications and for your specific job profile, for the specific role that you're playing in the organization, there are certain profile or certain skills or knowledge that you need to have, which has been defined. And based on that, certifications or courses are built, right? To take a Microsoft exam, we typically used to go to certification centers. So for Microsoft exams, you had Pearson VUE, which is the certification partner today. And we had a lot of centers or partners who are Pearson VUE centers, where we would go and give the exam. But today with the COVID situation, where you cannot get out of the house, right, where you're not allowed to travel, how do you then verify your knowledge or your learning, right? So today we are moving towards a more online exam, right? So today's session is all about what is the way in which we can take online exams today for Microsoft certifications, right? So certification, and you should be looking at this very seriously, because this is one way to increase your visibility, to improve your profile, to differentiate yourself from the peers, to validate, very important, to validate the knowledge and skills that you are picking up through the virtual programs or through self-paced learning. So let's understand Microsoft Online Exam. So what do you mean by an online exam? Basically, it's an exam that you can give from your home, right, or from the location that you choose. It is monitored by a proctor, you know, that Microsoft will appoint through a webcam. So the monitoring happens through your webcam, through the microphone. So you're continuously getting recorded. Your voice, your video is continuously getting recorded so that they can monitor and ensure that you are not cheating while giving the exam, right? So any of the role-based or fundamental exams which are delivered by Pearson VUE today can be taken using the Microsoft online exams, right? So like I said, rather than going to a certification center, you can sit at your own location and ensure you can give the exam. Now, which exams or which certifications can you give? So there is an exam list that is published by Microsoft, right? So I'll just take you to that list. So this is the role-based exams that are there. So you have various exams related to the cloud, Azure cloud, to data related exams. You have Microsoft 365 or Dynamics 365 exams. You have exams related to the modern desktops, where you have things like Exchange and Active Directory and so on. You have also Windows Server exams, right? So you can actually go to any of these exams. So for example, if I select Azure exams, you'll see an updated list, and this list is continuously getting updated. So these are the different certifications that are there, right? And you can choose which one you want to give. So for example, for a developer, you have a cloud developer, you have exam AZ204. This is one of the latest exams. So earlier the exam was AZ203, which has now got updated to AZ204, right? This is released recently, and continuously Microsoft will keep updating exams, okay? Similarly, you have fundamentals exam for Azure or the cloud. You have some very application specific exams like Microsoft Azure IoT exams, or you have data related exams that are there. So when you select a particular exam, right, you get the details, you get what skills are being measured and so on, and this is from where you can actually go and schedule an exam, right? So what exams can you take? You have the list that Microsoft provides. You can take all these exams online. It is an exam that you conduct from your own location using your own machine, but it is completely monitored via your webcam and microphone. So what are the things that you need to ensure you take care of before you even schedule the exam, right? So because you're going to take this exam from our location using our systems, Microsoft has certain checkpoints that we need to meet, or certain conditions that need to be met before we can take that exam. So conditions could be related to the location. So what is the place from where you're taking the exam? Request everybody to mute yourself, please. So conditions could be related to what are the system requirements? So what do you need to have installed on your machine? Whether there is some software on your machine which will interfere with the exams. So all those system checks need to be done, right? So let's understand what you need to check for before you can schedule an exam, or before you can know whether you can give the exam from your location. So before scheduling the exam, very important is first to do a system test, right? Which is to check your computer as well as the location from where you're going to give the exam, whether they are compatible based on the proctoring rules and regulations that Microsoft has. Right. So there are certain processes that are defined by Microsoft that need to be there. There are certain guidelines prescribed by Microsoft that need to be followed. So system test is first of all to check whether your machine, the computer from where you're giving the exam, as well as the location from where you're giving it, whether it's your home, your office or wherever, whether it is compatible with all the regulations of online exams of Microsoft. Right. It is critical that you do this first, because if you don't do this test and you schedule your exam and before the exam you anyways need to do this test, at that time if you realize something is not compatible, there's nothing you will be able to do, right? So your exam, you may have to kind of forfeit your exam on that term. So one is the system and location test, and I'll explain what happens in this test, right, a little later. Second is the confirmation of your ID, right? So any government issued ID is accepted. So in India, we can use our passport, driver's license, Aadhaar card, and so on. So you can use any government identification. So that is valid. And in this pre-test system test that happens, even your ID verification test is done, right? And then of course you review what are the protocols for testing, understand what are the protocols for testing before you can go and schedule the exam. So what are these protocols that need to be followed? But before we go there, what are the system requirements? What are the things that you need to have on a machine, right, before you can give the online exam? One, you need to download and install a Pearson secure browser, right? So there is a small exe that you'll need to install. And when you do the system test, it'll guide you through the steps of downloading and installing that, right? Second, online exams can be disrupted by proxy settings, any kind of network filtering rules that may be there, any kind of strict security restrictions that may be there, right? So ideally, if you're doing it from somewhere like office and you have these kind of firewalls and all, you should ideally ensure that none of these will interfere with your exam. Very important, you need to have local administrative permissions on your system, because you'll be installing those software, the secure browser and so on, when you're giving the exam, right? Disable any antivirus or any scanning that may happen, because that can affect the performance during the exam, right? Our performance, not your performance, but the performance of the system, right? And then, of course, you have to ensure that there are certain security software that you may have in your system which do not block, like execution of things like JavaScript or Flash players and so on, because that is something that would be used within your exam. So in your browser settings, you'll have to, security settings, you'll have to ensure this is enabled, right? So if you have any internet security or antivirus software, you may need to configure it to make the exceptions for these applications, as well as make an exception to download and install the secure browser. So these are some of the things that you need to take care of, right? From a hardware perspective, what do you need? What is supported hardware software perspective? So operating systems today for online exams, Microsoft Pearson View online exams, we can use a Windows 10 or a Windows 8.1 system. Windows 7 is no longer supported from January. And of course, your older releases of Windows are not supported. Your Windows operating system must pass the genuine Windows validation. That means no pirated Windows will be allowed. Today, Mac OS is also supported, which is 10.12 and above. Yes, you can do that, except for beta versions of the exams. So you can use Windows or Mac, but Linux and Unix are today not yet supported for exams. Like I said earlier in the earlier slide, you need to ensure that any kind of firewalls, any kind of security settings which may block certain content are disabled. Right? The display minimum resolution need to be 1024x768 in 16-bit color. The latest versions of your browsers need to be installed. So it supports Edge, Safari, Chrome, Firefox, all of these are supported. Your internet connectivity needs to be good because it's an online exam that you're giving. So your connection speed needs to be at least 1 Mbps, right? Both for the ingress and outgress, right? Egress. And then of course the webcam is going to be used because the proctor is going to monitor you through your webcam. So you have a minimum resolution for your webcam. The camera could be your built-in camera of your laptop, or you could connect an external camera to the laptop. Both are accepted. You need to also verify the sound system, whether your audio, microphone, speakers are working or not. You cannot be set on mute during the exam, right? Internet cookies need to be enabled and pop-up blockers need to be disabled. Right, so there'll be some pop-up windows that will be opened, right? So the system check actually, checks for all this on your machine. So you really don't need to, do this. It's good if you can actually ensure this all is applied before you do the system check. But your system check actually takes your system through the audio checks, webcam checks, internet connectivity checks, right? The compatibility softwares. Like I said, if you have any, for example, when I was taking the exam, I had any browser. Sharing application installed, and it told me anytime cannot be installed, so I had to go and or it cannot be running, so I had to go and actually stop the application. So it will do a lot of these checks to ensure that it can securely run and help you give the exam. So system test is very important, very critical, right? So please ensure you do all this before you even go and schedule your exam, register or schedule for your exam, right? I will be taking questions at the end. So if you have any questions, please put them on the chat window, and at the end of the session, I will address the questions. So moving to registering and scheduling the exam, right? So how do you do that? There are very simple steps for registering for an online exam, right? You need to go to the exam that you want to schedule or the certification for which you want to schedule the exam, right? And you will have a schedule exam button that is available on that exam page on the Microsoft site, right? Once you click on the schedule exam, it'll ask you to log in to your Microsoft account, which is associated with your MCP profile. So if this is the first Microsoft exam you're giving, please create the Microsoft account that you will be using and that you would like associated with your Microsoft exam profile, right? So ensure that. So as an MCP, that will become your access to, the benefits that you have as being a Microsoft certified professional. So you will have to log in with your credentials, your Microsoft account, and you'll have to first verify the profile, make any changes if required, and then you can continue to schedule the exam by moving to the Pearson View site. So there'll be a button where you can click to continue to Pearson View site. On the Pearson View site, to schedule an online exam, we need to select the option which says at my home or office, right? And then you accept the online exam policy. So let me show you this, right? So that we can see each and every step. So first step was, like I said, go and select the exam that you want to schedule. So for example, you can see over here, I have AZ220 exam selected, which is Microsoft Azure IoT Developer. And there is a button which says schedule exam, right? So if I click on schedule exam, it'll take me to the exam registration page and it'll ask me to log in if I have not already signed into my Microsoft account. So let me log in. And once I've done this, like I said, it brings up your profile so you can verify the profile and continue. And once you verify the profile, it will ask you to proceed. Now, if you're a Microsoft employee, of course, you can link your Microsoft ID to or your Microsoft identity to your MCP profile, right? In our case, we will just click on continue scheduling the exam. So we'll go to the Pearson View site. Now over here, there are various ways in which you can give an exam, right? So one, of course, is going to a registered center, which we could have done earlier. But today's session is all about how do we give online exam, right? So for that, we will need to select at home or office, right, as the option. And notice over here, it's asking you, if you're going to schedule this exam, please ensure you've run the pre-check. Pre-check is the system check that I was talking about. So if I click on this, right, notice it's going to check your microphone, it's going to check your internet speed, and then it's going to check your webcam, right? So it's going to do all this. Plus, after doing this, it's going to take you to the process of, you know, checking the other things, like checking the location, checking your system by installing the secure browser. That's all this will be done. So if I click on next, okay, so this is a preliminary check. So it just checks the internet speed, your audio and your video streaming that is there, right? So from here, if I select at home or office, if I click on next, right, like I said, it'll ask you for accepting the online policies. Right, so you need to ensure this. The last paragraph is very critical. Right, so we need to select that we accept these policies. So last paragraph is very critical, like I said. So we actually acknowledge and agree, right, that if we are detected as being, if a third party is detected as being present in the location from where we are giving the exam, that is whether they are visible or not. And even if you hear, even if the proctor hears a voice, right? Our exams could be, canceled, or our exam could be nullified, right? So even if a third party is detected in the location or any voice is overheard in any manner, right? During the exam time, the test will be terminated and will not receive any score. Right? So that is something that we need to keep in mind. Also, please understand that by acknowledging this, right, we are actually allowing them to terminate the exam session. And we lose that particular fee that we have paid. So it's critical that, and I will explain what are those policies that you need to follow when you're giving the exams. We'll yet come to that. So we are just registering right now for the exam. And it shows you the details of the exam. We verify the details. Right? And you have again information about the online proctoring. Right, so this is the page on Microsoft site which gives you all the details, right, of what you need to ensure. Sorry. When you click on next, this is when it will actually show you the dates and, we need to select the proctoring, the proctor language. So when we are communicating with the proctor, in what language will we communicate? So in India, most of the cases, it will be English only. And then you can select the date and time when you want to give the exam. When you select or click on a particular date, it will show you the time when the exam is available. Right? So in this case, it's showing me 8 p.m. Today is available for giving this exam. So if I select 8 p.m., right, it shows me the details of my appointment. So it shows me the date, time, which is the exam, right, what is the length of the exam and so on. And then I can proceed to check out. Right? And over here, you will go and pick, make the payments. If you have an exam voucher, you can give the voucher details and so on. And go and register for the exam. Right? Now, like I said, before you give the exam, you need to ensure you perform the system test. So this is the link from where you can get information about the system test, right? And we've seen that, that page from where you can get all that information. So it gives you details of what you need to do. Right, so you need to accept this, agree to these policies also. And then you are directed to the payment page where you can select your mode of payment. Right? So this is how you would do it. And if you have an exam voucher, you can specify the voucher code here and apply it and give the exam and pay for the exam. Right? Okay. These are the steps. We selected the exam, clicked on schedule exam. We logged into our Microsoft account, verified the profile. We selected at home or office as the option because we want to give the online exam. We accepted the online exam policies, right? We selected the language for communication with the proctor. Then we selected the exam date and time. And then we clicked on proceed to check out to make the payment and confirm the appointment. Okay. And we saw how to do this. Now let's look at certain policies, practices, procedures that you need to follow for or either during the exam or prior to the exam. What is it that we need to do? So first of all, related to location, whether it's office or home, right, the location has to meet certain requirements, right? So if it's an office or conference room, it must be walled. It must have a closed door. It must be free from any disruptions. The same applies, of course, for home, right? No other third person should be in your room, right, during the exam. So even if they, see somebody or hear somebody, right, you could be in trouble. when you're communicating with the proctor or the greeter, right? That is when they will walk you initially, when you log into the exam, they'll initially walk you through, you know, testing of your system, checking your location and all that. So this communication with the proctor can have, can be done in multiple ways. So one is of course phone. So during the check-in process, the proctor or greeter will ask you for your phone number so that they can communicate with you during the exam if required over the phone, right? Of course, after they have completed the check-in process, you will be asked to put your phone out of hand's reach, but close enough for you to hear it, right? So that if there is some issue, they can connect with you. So that is there. You can communicate with them over a chat window, right? So you have a chat window that you can invoke and bring up to communicate with the proctor. Of course, your microphone needs to be on, like I discussed, right? So when you're during the exam, you can even talk to the proctor, right? And the language in India, at least it's English, that will be used. There can be no personal belongings anywhere around the area from where you are taking the exam. That means the desk from which you are taking the exam should be free of any kind of electronic devices, watches, wallets, purses, any kind of scarves, books, notepads, right? None of this material, any kind of writing material like pencils, pens, right? None of that can be near. So your desk should be clutter free. None of these things should be in and around, or they should not be even within hand's reach, right? So your proctor in the initial check-in process will ensure this is there by asking you to, move your camera around the room and on the location on your desk or wherever you're giving the exam from. So they will ensure you don't have any of these around, and if it is there, they'll ask you to move it. You may be asked to check your pockets, right? If you're wearing some kind of a coat or, you know, some kind of a jacket, you may be asked to, ensure that your pockets are empty. If you're wearing long sleeves, they may ask you to, you know, roll up your sleeves to see if there's nothing hidden under it or nothing written on your arms. Right. If you're wearing a tie, you may be asked to, you know, kind of lift the tie to show there's nothing behind it. If you are having a long hair, or if your hair is covering your ears, you may be asked to move it behind the ears so that they can see whether you're wearing any kind of Bluetooth earpiece and so on. Okay. So all these things they will be monitoring and checking as a pre check. No breaks, no eating, no drinking, nothing around the place from where you're taking the exam, right? So no bio breaks are also allowed. So please ensure you take care of all your needs before you, log into the exam. So your exam score will be invalidated, right? And you cannot resume the exam. So no eating, no drinking, no chewing of gum, anything during the exam. So you cannot even have a glass of water or a bottle of water close to you, right? No exam assistance. So during the exam, nobody can enter your room, right? If they even suspect that is happening, your exam will be terminated, right? Even something like reading the question out loud, right? The proctor will tell you, please don't do that, because they don't know if you're reading it loud enough for somebody in the next room to hear it or whatever, right? So you need to be very careful. You can use the whiteboard provided by the Pearson View browser, right, to kind of make notes or note down something during the exam, but you're not allowed any kind of paper or whiteboard physically around you during the exam, right? If you have any questions related to content, unfortunately, Proctor cannot help you. So in that case, you will have to take it up with Microsoft support after the exam. But if it's anything related to the logistics of the exam, definitely the Proctor can help you. So let's say the exam is not moving ahead, there is some issue with, you know, the exam not showing up properly and all that, you can definitely ask. But anything related to something in the question, the Proctor cannot really help you. Please keep this in mind, the Proctor will be continuously monitoring you by audio and video while you take the exam. So in fact, when you schedule the exam, one of the policies that you agreed to is the, you gave Microsoft the rights to schedule, to kind of record your video and audio during the exam. So this is scheduling the exam, and these are some protocols that you need to follow to ensure that you can give the exam properly, right? So now let's go to, while we are taking the exam, what are the things that we need to take care of? Now to launch the exam, again, if you've logged into your Microsoft Learning site, right, you can simply go to your benefits and exam dashboard. So this is microsoft.com/learning/dashboard. So you go to that site. Now, since I'm already logged in, right, it'll take me to my dashboard, learning dashboard. Right, and this is my dashboard. Right, so over here you can see the appointments section. It's showing if there is any kind of exam that is scheduled, right? So you can click on start a previously scheduled online proctored exam. So click on this and it will take you to the page where it will actually show you which are your scheduled exams. Right, so in this case, for example, I have scheduled a exam for AZ301. Right, so you can see that it is being scheduled. Correct. So you can go to your page under appointments. You can click on start a previously scheduled proctored exam. And when the exam appears, yeah, you will have a button called begin exam. So naturally, this exam is not yet due, right? Otherwise, I would have got a begin exam button over here. Right? So that's how you can start your exam, by clicking on the begin exam button. Please take care of the following, or note the following. It may take about 5 minutes after you click on begin exam for you to get connected to the greeter or the proctor. The entire check-in process that the proctor will take you through, or the greeter will take you through, can take approximately 15 minutes. So it is advised that you log in at least 15 minutes before the exam, so that you can have this process done before your exam time. The begin exam button becomes available about half an hour before the exam. So if I've scheduled my exam for, let's say, 3 o'clock in the afternoon, the begin exam button will be enabled at around 2:30 in the afternoon, and it'll be available till 3:15. So 15 minutes after your scheduled time, you have that much grace period before you can start your exam. After the 15 minutes, that begin button, exam button will be disabled, then you will not be able to take your exam, right? So you have about 45 minutes, half an hour before the scheduled time and 15 minutes after the scheduled time when you can start your exam, right? It's very important, please ensure you've turned off browser pop-up blockers. Now, what is this check-in process, right? So after connecting with the greeter, right, as a part of your check-in process, these are the things that you need to do. So there will mainly be identity verification, right, and the scan of your location, right? So these two things are the main checks that will happen, right, during check-in. So in identity verification, you are expected to keep your ID ready, right? through your webcam, a photo will be taken and a photo of your ID will also be taken, and they will be matched to ensure you are the same person. Please ensure you have an ID which has the exact same name as what is there on your profile, right? Once the ID is verified, then it'll ask, the greeter will ask you to scan the entire location from where you're giving the exam. So with your webcam, your phone, or your laptop, you'll be asked to, you know, show or take photographs of the left hand side of the location from where you're giving the exam, the area facing that location or behind that location or the right of that location. So you'll be asked to kind of scan the entire area, right? If there are things that should not be there, they'll ask you to move it. Like I said, we know what is not allowed, right? So unless this is done and they are satisfied with the surroundings, yeah, you cannot start your exam, right? So please ensure there are no additional monitors, there are no additional computers. If you do have them, please ensure they're unplugged. Please ensure the monitors are not facing you, right? And remember, as per the policies, your desk or the location from where you're giving the exam should not have any of items like books, notepads, papers, pencils, pens, anything around, right? It's very important. Now, during the exam, right, after this check-in process is completed, the proctor is not really going to contact you. You will just have a button to start the exam and you can start it. The proctor will not contact you in any way unless there is an issue, right? But please remember, through the webcam, through the audio, they will be monitoring you, right? If there is an issue, the proctor will try to first contact you on chat. If you don't respond, then or if that doesn't work, the proctor will call you on the phone. That is why your phone has to be out of hands reach, but close enough for you to hear it if there is any need for the proctor to connect. Okay. Now, people who are not given Microsoft exams, people who have given Microsoft exam are aware of the kind of questions that will be asked in the exam. But people who have not given Microsoft exams, there are different types of screens that you will see. There are different types of questions that you will need to answer. Right? Like the most basic, of course, is multiple choice, right? Where you're given four or five answers and you have to select the right one. Sometimes you're given four or five answers and you need to select multiple options because the combination of options may be the right answer, right? Sometimes you may have to do a drag and drop. So you'll be given options on the left hand side and you may be having to drag and drop in the right sequence on the right hand side, right? So on the Microsoft YouTube site, you have some small videos which show you what are the different types of questions that are there, right? So for example, if I show you one of them,
to answer a drag and drop question, you will need to select and drag answer options from the source area on the left of the screen to the
right. So as you can see, there are various videos that are available on the YouTube channel of Microsoft that you can view it. And on this page, like I told you, which is about online exams, you will have the links to all these videos that are there below. Right. So you can over here on the Microsoft Certification Exams, You'll be able to see the links to all these. So what are the different types? For example, there is a case study question that can occur. So what is this case study question all about? So a case study typically will have multiple buttons which will show you or explain to you what is the problem statement, what is the existing environment, what is the technical requirement, the business requirement, right? So all these are options that you can go through first before you actually start answering the questions. So this is how you can, like I said, view different types of questions that are there. Right? So there are many types of questions. So during the exam, you'll have to go through the different exams and questions and answer them. You also have a review screen where you can review the answers you've given. And then finally, of course, end your exam. Once you complete your exam, you should ideally get the results immediately on the screen. Sometimes, like we saw earlier, there are some certifications which have lab sections, where you may need to do some activities on the Azure portal, or you may need to write some code. In that scenario, it may take some time for your scores to be calculated, right? So you can always go back to the benefits and exam dashboard and then see the scores and download the scores from there. Right. So if I go back to that page, to my dashboard, you can see view score reports. You can always come back here and view the score reports for all the exams that you have given. Right. So you can check this out, and it shows you pass, fail, whatever. And then when you click on a particular score report, it'll show you what is the transcript of that exam. Okay, so you can open that and view it. So this is available to you, right, at any time. And of course, you can go and uninstall the Pearson View Secure Browser that is installed once you have completed your exam. So let's see a walkthrough of this entire process that I've explained, especially when you have to start taking the exam. So what is the check-in? What is the pre-system check? What is the actual check-in process when you're giving the exam? So we saw a video showing what I explained as the entire process, right? So that is exactly what we will need to be doing when we're giving the online exam. So quick FAQ, so that some of the commonly asked questions. So can you take the exam if your system test, if your system does not pass the system test? No. Please understand this. You should not even register for the exam if your system does not pass the system test. Yeah. So having a system which has, you know, passed the system test as well as being able to take a clear photo of your identification is very critical during the exam. Can I request you all to please mute yourselves? A lot of times people feel that, you know, cheating in an online test will be easier, if you are going to a center, a certification center, and taking the test. So they are wondering how secure are online exams. So Microsoft assures that, first of all, the secure browser that you download and install, right? That itself enforces, strict rules about what applications can be running and what cannot be running throughout the entire testing process. A proctor is continuously monitoring you via video and audio, right? All your audio video is getting recorded. So in case they want to, they can review the audio video if they want to check if any cheating happened. And cheaters are decertified, their certifications are removed, and they are banned from taking future exams. So online exams definitely are not less secure than going to a testing center. If I want to take multiple exams, can I choose different ways in which you can give the exam? Yes. So for example, I have done some exams which are in the testing center. After the COVID scenario, a lot of us have started taking online exams. So you can mix and match. It's not a problem at all. How long do you have for completing the exam? The time for the exam is the same as the time you would have if you had gone to a testing center. So that does not change whether you're giving the exam online or in a testing center, right? Are they more difficult? Are the exams more difficult? No, the exams are the same in both places, whether you're taking it online or in a testing center. So don't worry about that. What if you want to take any notes when you're giving the exam? Well, yes, you can take notes, but like I said, no paper or notebooks, physical paper, notebooks, pencils near you, but there are online whiteboard options that are provided as part of the software which you can use. Right, and you can access that by clicking the appropriate icon on the screen. So if you have any issues when you're giving online exams, if there are questions related to registration, then you can connect with PearsonView support, right? At the time of registrations, you would have those links provided to you. If there is any technical issue during the exam delivery while you're taking the exam, the proctor will help you resolve it. If required, the proctor will also share an incident report number with you, which you can then give as a reference to the support of PearsonView. But please remember, other than registration related or technical issues, actual content related issues cannot be addressed by the proctor. So I throw this up for any questions that you may have. So let me just.
Yeah, this is Ashish here. Can you hear me?
Yes, Ashish, I can hear you. Please go ahead.
Yeah, I think this one common question what we have in chat is what's if there's a power outage or if there's any problem with the broadband connection for 10 to 15 minutes. What are the options we're going to have there?
Sure. So there are some guidelines that are provided. So like they say, you should not be on a, you should not be giving the exam on a mobile hotspot. If you are having wireless, then ensure it is a strong wireless connectivity you have. They would prefer a wired connectivity, but like we would not have that maybe in our homes. Not everybody would have them in their homes. So if you're using wireless, then ensure that you have a good connectivity. In spite of doing all this, if there is an issue, right, the proctor is there to help you. And whenever it comes online, you can always connect, or you can connect to the Pearson support. But it's an online exam, so you need to ensure that you have a good connectivity. So please don't try giving the exam on a mobile hotspot and so on. Ensure you have a good, even if it's wireless, ensure you have a good wireless connectivity.
So the follow-up question there is, if there's any power outage at your home, will we be able to retake the exam or replay the exam at some other time, or it's just gone?
So that depends on how the support will take it. So like I said, if there is any issue that happens, like a power outage and all, when you try to reconnect, the proctor will be able to help you, and you should be able to raise a support with Pearson View, where they should be able to help you with that.
Thanks.
Any other questions? Swanand, you had a question. How can we show proctor the area by moving camera as laptop camera is fixed? I think the video would have answered your question. You'll actually have to pick up the laptop and move it around to show the area around. How frequently can we reschedule the exam? So the rescheduling rules are fixed and they are there on the registration page, Nayan. So I think if you reschedule about 6 or 8 days before the exam, then there is no charges for it. But if it is less than that, there is a certain amount of charge that you need to be paid. Now that is up to you, Nayan, whether you want to take a practice test or not. A lot of people do take the one-on-one offer, especially when Microsoft also has some discounts going on that. So that if they don't clear it in the first attempt, they can do it in the second. But that is a very relative, decision. So person to person, it may change, right? So if you've prepared well, you may not even need any kind of practice exam or any kind of second attempt. Mahesh, honestly, I kind of differ in your opinion, because we have successfully taken online exams and it's pretty easy to do it. And this is a time when you really will be able to, at least spend some time and focus on it and ensure that, you can build your skills. So Swanand, no, online exams are not discounted in any way. So the price for the online exam and the exam, if you give the exam in the testing center, is the same. Yeah, so any other questions? So like Priyanka said in the beginning, we have a lot of sessions that we are doing for certifications in the months of May and June. So please do attend register for the sessions. We are giving them at a very high discounted rate of 17,500. These are for all the advanced certification courses on Azure. You get an Azure pass and an exam voucher as part of that that price, along with the training for whatever is the duration official curriculum by an MCT MCT trainer. So please take advantage of that. Priyanka and Manish can share the details with you.
Thank you so much, Ashwini ma'am, for such a wonderful session. And we are going to mail you the feedback form. And if you want the any certification related details, just mail me or WhatsApp me. All of you have my mail ID. So thank you once again for attending and joining this webinar. Thank you so much.
Thank you.